it's Tam. Welcome back, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm actually, as you can see from the title, doing a glue book tag. For those of you who have been here on my channel for a while, you know this is something that I do here on my channel. It's one of the types of videos that I do, and so someone came across, I guess, one or more of those videos, and they wanted to tag me in a glue book tag that they're having here. And so I am coming on to participate. And so basically it's a list of questions. If you've never been tagged, it's usually requiring you to do something. The tag is prompting you to respond in some way. People get tagged in journaling tags, art tags, I've seen all kind of tags. Like, it's basically like a little, it's not a challenge. I don't want to say challenge, but it's like where it's just like a game. I'll say it's more of a game than a challenge. Just, you know, our way to have fun here on social media. And so something that brings us joy and you see the same thing or something similar brings someone else joy and you guys just get together and you have fun. So I'm going to answer the questions here that, the tag consists of. It's 10 questions, and so I'll be answering them in this video. So the very first question is, how many glue books do I have? I only have these two so far, and this one is my most recent one. This one was one that I made by hand, and I just put some old book paper along with some just regular copy paper, and I put some of this like off-white eggshell. I don't know if you guys can see that because my camera is disrespectful and it doesn't do what I want it to do most of the time. But this paper right here isn't white. I don't know if the camera is going to pick that up or not, but it's kind of like a cream color. So I put those three types of paper in this book. Magazine paper, book paper, white, just regular white copy paper, and this off-white paper. And I made this by hand, so I put these three ring binder clips on it, and that's, you know, just for me to, when I get ready to use it, I can fold it like this. I can fold it like this, and I won't have any issue with it being where I can't open it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it won't lay flat. So I made it this way for this purpose. But after making this, I still went into a thrift store, and I ran across, or with the intentions of finding a book like this. This is just an old, decorating book, and so it is hardcover, and I just use it to glue images down that I cut out of magazines and different, you know, like here's one, and I just did some eyes, some lips, a nose, and so I just put a face together using a variety of different facial features that I found in a magazine. And I'm a quote person. Some people can just do a page and they don't have to have anything on it. The way my brain works, I just have to have a quote. So I put down quotes on these pages that I do in my glue books. So this is currently the only two that I have. So the second question is, which book is my favorite? That is going to be hard for me to choose. But I guess I have to pick one. The question said, which one is your favorite? I would probably have to say, honestly, if I'm being honest, I like both of them. But if I had to choose one, it would probably be this one. And it's just basically because of the design. And it's because of the fact that I'm able to lay it flat. And I guess that would be my determining factor. But I like this one just as well as I do this one. But if I had to pick a favorite, it would be this one probably. And it's handmade. I mean, you can't go wrong with handmade. Handmade, hands down, will probably always be my choice. Something that you hand make, you put in effort and you put in time. You didn't just go in a store to buy it. Not that there's anything wrong with that. But just me personally, I feel like if you hand make something, you have made a conscious decision to see something through, right? So, can't go wrong with handmade. The third question, which page is my favorite? Now, I've done a variety of different pages in this one, which was my first one. So, I have more pages in this one than I do the other one. But if I had to pick a favorite, it would be this one, the owl page. And I put a quote on it. Well, basically, I put a scripture on it. And it says, don't be wise in your own eyes. And I actually did a... And this is totally unrelated, but most of you know. If you don't, now you know. I have a Bible journaling channel. It's linked down below if you're interested in going over there. But I did a, I just did a Bible journaling page in a brand new Bible that I got from one of my YouTube friends, Sherry. The same scripture. And that's what that looks, that's what that looks like. So I did, the same scripture in my Bible that I did here in my glue book. And I put an owl on this page because owls are supposed to be wise. So, but on this one, I kind of did like a fall autumn theme, but it's the same scripture. Lord, let me not be wise in my own eyes. And this one, don't be wise in your own eyes. And that's coming from Proverbs 3:7. So I would have to say that this is my favorite page. Okay, fourth question. What are my favorite images to harvest? I would have to say that I don't have any one particular image, but it does says it says images with an S. So I would assume that that's more than one. I like florals. I like animals. I like people. Those would have to be my for three favorite things. Florals, animals, and people are the things that I like to harvest the most. But I, you know, I'll harvest other things. Like most of my pages consist of an animal or a person, and I like flowers too. So I would probably say that those three are my favorite images to harvest. I have a Michelle Obama page in here. I'm looking for it because I always like to show it. I can never find it. That's the weirdest. It's blue, but that's not it. I can't even find it. I was going to show y'all my Michelle Obama page. And it's missing. Oh, there it is. And it says Joy. She's got a big smile on her face. And I just thought she looked happy, joyful. And so I just put the word Joy on the top of that page. Kind of blended her in with the background. On the page itself, I put some washi down the side, and that was that. Okay, so how do I store my images, and how are they organized? Okay, first of all, I have some images. Like, I'll cut out images, and I'll put them in, like, a little cellophane bag here on my desk. But honestly and truly, 100% of the time, I leave my images inside the magazine. I don't have no more space to put no images. So I don't want to create, like, I don't want to start cutting stuff out of magazines with nowhere to put it. I'm working with a very small space, and most of my images stay inside the magazine. I don't, you know, take them out and try to accumulate a big pile of them. I'll just continue to go through the same magazines over and over, because the thing about it is, I don't cut images from any magazine that I don't like. So I could just continue to look over and over in the same magazines and find images every time I look in it that I want to use. And not just for glue booking, I also use the same images for my journaling as well. So I don't store them anywhere, guys. So I have not accumulated. I mean, I have plenty of magazines, and I guess I can show you guys that if you're interested. But let me see here. And I don't cut them out, you know. So if you guys can see this shelf right here, it's like a little cubby hole. And all of these are filled with magazines. So much so, I had to start putting them on top. And then right above that, I have some books here. And like, I'll store stuff in some of, I mean, not store. I'll cut images out of some of these books that I have up here as well and glue them down. But for the most part, these are all of my magazines. These are the books that I pull from when I want to search for images to glue book or to journal with. Okay, so the next question is, do I have themed books? I do not have themed journaling books, glue books. I just glue down whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's basically for me, and my glue booking process is just a creative outlet. So, and with glue booking, it doesn't have to be any theme, and it doesn't have to be perfect. I can put down in here whatever I want, however much of it I want, however often I want, or, you know, whatever the case may be. I just don't have any rhyme or reason to this. I just glue and express myself. So you can see on several pages, I've used paint and stuff, and most of these are just magazine images. This is from one of my floral magazines. This one I think came from the same floral magazine. Then I'll pull images from just magazine subscriptions that I have. This is, I think, Essence magazine. And this is an old magazine that a free magazine, an old, one of those, not old, it's like a free magazine that they have sitting outside of like the grocery store and stuff. I just pulled one of those and I just combined a smile page. I call it a smile page because everybody in it is smiling. So a page that makes me feel, you know, happy and joyful, and it makes me smile to see other people smile. So I don't have any themes. I'm just random. I am a random type of person. Honestly, whatever it is that I do, no matter what kind of craft it is, it's usually random. It has no theme to it. Okay, the next question is, do you have plans to start a new book? And if so, what size and will it be themed? Do I have plans to start a new book? Yes, and it's probably going to more than likely be, and this is my washi journal. And I got this. This is one of those Excel notebooks from Walmart. And this is probably going to be the next size I go into. I like this size. Let me see if I can. I don't even think I know what size this is. Honestly, it reminds me of the Hobonichi A5. The Hobonichi, I think it's A5 Cousin Avec. I think that's what size this is. And I don't know what size it is. Maybe I should look that up before I started this video. But let me see if I can find my phone and I can tell you guys what size it is. Okay, guys, I had to go on a hunt to see what size this is. This is a 7.5 by 9 journal. And I got this from Walmart from their clearance section. And I think it was maybe $4 or $5. I don't even remember. It's been a while. But this is probably the size that I use next. And I'll just go to Walmart and get one of these. Probably won't find one on the clearance aisle. But this is probably the size that I'm going in next. Will it be themed? Probably not. It's probably just going to be a random one just like these. I'm just interested in changing sizes just a little bit. And so this is the size that I think I'm going to be most comfortable transitioning into, or not transitioning, because I'll still be using these, but just adding. This is the size that I think I'll be comfortable with adding to the two glue books that I already have. And I just found that at Walmart in their clearance section one day, and basically I bought it because it was yellow, because yellow is one of my favorite colors. So now the eighth question is, where do I get my magazine images? I get my most 99% of my images I get from magazines that I like. And so I'm just going to zoom in just a little bit closer to show you guys what they are. I'm just going to bring some here on screen. Now, the very first one that I like the most, and I think most of you who have been with me a while already know, is Daphne's Diaries. Daphne's Diary. Daphne's Diary is one of my most beloved magazines. Now, I got to tell you, she is expensive. Daphne is not cheap. She is, I usually get them from Barnes and Noble, but I did go ahead and get a subscription. And Daphne's Diary is coming from the UK. Not the UK. It's coming from the Netherlands. It's coming from the Netherlands. And I have found them in Barnes and Noble. And I think the Barnes and Noble price is somewhere around $15 a magazine. For some people, that is expensive. For me, it's expensive, but I don't mind spending that money on something that I know I like, that the quality is where I think it needs to be for it to be that expensive. So Daphne's Diary is number one on the list. It is one of my most beloved magazines, and I get images out of here. The second one I would have to say is Flow. I love Flow magazine. It's also an expensive one that is not U.S. based. This magazine also comes from, I want to say it comes from the Netherlands as well. Let me see. I want to say it does. Don't quote me on that. I can't find it in there. And I also like Breathe. And I think Breathe is a U.S. magazine. I'm not sure. Nope. It says printed in the U.K. right down there. I just love magazines that's not from the U.S., obviously, but that's just my own personal preference. Let me tell y'all, when I find something that I like and it's of the quality that I think it should be in order for me to like it, that's just how I am. So Like, these images, I'll cut these out and I'll glue them down. I mean, that's, and they're matte. I think that's one of the things that attracts me to these particular magazines. They're not shiny, glossy, like American magazines most of the time are. This is a glossy page here, but 99% of the pages in this book aren't glossy. They're just matte pages, and I like that. And Daphne's diary, she has glossy pages in here too, but a huge portion of the pages in these books are matte. And I like not having that shine on my pages. I just like, you know, just matte paper. But, put a but there, one of the magazines that I do like using that is shiny, glossy, is Birds in Bloom. That's one of the magazines that I predominantly used for this one when I started off. So these images on these two pages are from Birds in Bloom, and these two images are from Birds in Bloom. So is this one. This one came out of an Essence magazine, I think it was. And this one came from a Daphne's Diary. And this one, like I said, came from a free magazine that sits outside of the grocery stores. This came from Essence. And this one came from a Daphne's Diary. Or maybe, I think it may have come from Flo. I don't remember where I got that one from. But it's a matte image. It doesn't have that glossy shine to it that, you know, I was talking about earlier. So I just like images like that. And so I don't mind paying, you know, for what I like. I'm not going to pay a lot for something that I know I don't like and I'm not going to use. But Birds in Bloom was also a subscription that I got that I no longer have, because I have plenty of these magazines, so I don't need any more. But I'll go through here and I'll just find stuff that I like, and I'll cut it out and I'll glue it to the page. There's an eagle. So I think the owl that I used in the page that I told you guys was my favorite page was similar. It was like a big owl on a page, and I just cut it out and I used it. And so those are the number one places that I'll go for my images. Now, the question is, what is my favorite glue to use? I'll go back and forth between just a regular glue stick, and this one is from the Dollar Tree, and I also like the Elmer's glue, that the purple glue that dries clear. I'll use that one a lot, and just regular glue, just regular old craft glue. So, you know, it depends on whether or not I want the page to buckle. Like, I know wet glue, like this craft glue, it's going to warp your pages. Like, what do you call it? It's going to wrinkle it. But what I have found is after it gets through wrinkling it, and if you're going to put your book back up on the shelf, you close it, press it together, slide it back on the shelf, and it'll be okay. It'll flatten out. So that's not a problem. And those are the glues I like. My last question is number 10. What advice would you give to a newbie? My advice to a newbie is the same advice that I would give to a newbie, no matter what it is you're doing, not just glue booking, is to find fun in it. Don't do something just because everybody else is doing it. Make sure it's something that you enjoy, because guess what? If you enjoy it, there's nothing nobody can say to stop you from doing it. Nobody can discourage you. Nobody can make you feel bad about your outcome of your books and your journaling and whatever. I'm sorry. I posted a video and I got people commenting. But if you do it because you like it, it's, you know, more than likely it's going to be long term, and you're not going to have to worry about feeling discouraged or comparing what you do to someone else and making you feel like you're not good enough or any of that. Try some videos, or not videos, but try to do some glue booking when no one else is watching. So if you're a YouTuber, or if you like to post your stuff on social media, try not doing that in the beginning. Just learn to enjoy it and love it yourself. And then once you become a lover of what you do when no one's watching, then put it out there. And when you put it out there, you're not going to care about what people say about it, right? Because people can be very critical of something that they're not familiar with, or something that they haven't tried yet. So make sure that, you know, if you like it, you put it out there, and you're going to have the haters coming. You're going to already have developed that love for your own art, your own creations, your own journaling, your own glue booking, and you're not really going to care what anybody else says. And if you do care what someone else says, develop, you know, a comeback, you know. Just be able to say, you know what, you may not like it, and that's okay. It's not for you, it's for me, and it's for people who do like it. And just end it like that, right? So, that was the last question. That's all I have for you guys. Y'all know I love you so much. I love jumping on here talking to you guys. Everything about me and my channels is in the description below. Check it out. If you want to know something, it's probably below. My address, my email address, my Instagram, my other channel, all that stuff is down there, my Etsy shop. So if you want to know anything about me, just check out the description box. And as always, I just love jumping on here talking to you guys. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye.